All right, I'd like to welcome you to the Rotary Club of Maplewood, North St. Paul, and Oakdale. Happy Friday morning to everybody. We are going to start off. We're going to stand up and have Carla lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Not Carla, you're going to join us. Thank you. Yes. Thank you. And Anne is going to have our five-way test. Hold on.
Check.
The five-way test of the things we think, say, and do. Is it the truth? Is it... Pardon?
We were going to join you.
Oh, I'm sorry. Number one. Is it the truth? Number two, is it fair to all concerned? Number three, will it build goodwill and better friendships? Number four, will it be beneficial to all concerned? And number five, is it fun?
This is what happens when we're on Zoom for a whole year. All right, was everyone greeted this morning by Barb? Fabulous. We're going to hand the mic over to Barb for some words of encouragement or invocation.
Let us turn to the source of spiritual strength that is within each of us and pray. May those of us who have share with those who have not. May those of us who can do for those who cannot. May those of us who are loved love those who are not. And may we all live our lives so that the world is better off for having had us. Amen.
Thank you, Barb. All right, it looks like we don't have a morning wake-up quiz. Go ahead and have a seat, because I think Randy is in Iowa. So, no quiz this morning. And then next up, we will welcome our sergeants-at-arms to come up and up, down.
Well, good morning, everybody.
Good morning. Sylvia, how are you doing?
No, you're Sylvia.
Last few minutes, I got transformed.
Isaac put Sylvia's name
today. I wasn't paying attention. I picked up Sylvia's name. I said, oh, no. We'll figure out. Anyway.
Did you have a good week?
Fantastic.
Anything I had a to good report?
Round. I had a good round, too. Almost, I should say. Yeah. What was that, Wednesday morning? Yeah. Goodrich started a round. Third hole, lightning right in my face. Pick up my ball, I'm gone. So
you got three holes in.
I got three holes, three good ones.
They owe you 15.
On the third one, almost a birdie, and then the lightning took it off. So, week wasn't bad. Anybody else?
I'm so glad you were safe.
Oh, Nina, yes. I'm glad. I am glad, too.
I want, in celebration of Suni Lee, who won the all-around women's gymnastics. I have $10 for the Salvation Army food shelf because they service the Asian community more. So that's for the local Salvation Army food shelf here.
Thank you, Nana. 10 big ones.
Very nice. Thank you. Suni's watch party was in Oakdale. That's part of our jurisdiction. So I think we're claiming her as one of ours, right?
Just want to make a quick announcement. Back to school is happening. Kids will be in school this year, and I am planning a backpack supply cookout party. If you are interested in helping us out on that day, we're going to have a cookout, bouncy house, games for kids, all that good fun stuff. Come talk to me. There's also flyers up by the kitchen sink up there. It will be on August 17th from 4 to 6. That's a Tuesday.
And who do the backpacks go to?
They go to kids.
Here locally?
Here locally. Families can come. They can eat. They can have fun. And, yeah. anybody. We're getting over 250 backpacks. We must get rid of them all. If you guys want to help, there will be opportunities to play games with kids. I need volunteers to help with kids. We have recently lost our youth director as of Tuesday. So there is a vacant spot here in the Salvation Army at this particular corps. So if you know anybody who might be good for the job, connect with me on that. And also we'll need help registering families for backpacks because this is a social service event. Every family needs to get registered. So that registration process, helping them fill out the paperwork, it's really pretty simple. So yeah, I can use all the help I can get. 4 to 6.
Wear your Rotary t-shirt.
Wear the Rotary t-shirt. I will be wearing my Salvation Army t-shirt, but I will be representing you guys too.
Excellent. Myra. Our third sergeant at arms. How are you, Myra?
I am retired, but I am good.
Retired?
Yeah. I think it's Randy, right? Randy still sergeant.
I took her job.
I gave it to you, my dear.
I'm still leaning on you though to help.
No worries. I was thinking that would be a great opportunity for membership drive and get our t-shirts exposed and our club exposed. That would be a perfect opportunity.
So your new focus is on membership, and did you attend the meeting last night?
Yes, thanks, Barb, for organizing. That was wonderful. And hopefully we can come up with a few ideas there.
Very good. Did we have anybody else go? 1, 2, 3, 4. 5. Good. Yeah. Excellent. Thank you for doing that. No. No home run balls came over the highway. Yeah. I'm all talk. It did not happen.
All right.
I better pay a buck for that, I suppose. I'll also pay a buck. My youngest daughter, Brooklyn, played in her last game on the very same field this week, and she's going through a little bit of a slump, but they tied the game in the last inning, and she was up with the bases loaded, and somehow, some way, she made her way to first base and scored someone scored their winning run, so
oh.
I'll pay for that one.
All right. I see Terry has something to share with us.
Good morning. Tomorrow I leave for Austin, Texas for my daughter's birth, our first grandchild from her, baby Aurora, on Monday. It's C-section, so it's planned. And she'll be going to neonatal, the baby. So the baby's about a month early. So there are some complications there, but everything so far is good. Last week, I made the Wall Street Journal. This is a memorial of Don Regan, our founder of Premier Bank. And the family put together his life story in the Wall Street Journal. And I've got plenty of copies here if you would like a copy and read about Don Regan. I did make the paper, so that was good. That's it.
Thank you.
Very cool. Now, this is not your daughter's first child in Austin, right? They have...
This is the first one.
It is the first.
So
this is grandchild number 3. Congrats.
Well, I guess I should put a buck in because we are going to be celebrating one of our own on the 4th of August. Her name is Kyra Kondi, and she's going to be in the Olympics for climbing. So there's going to be a watch party, and we're all going to be rooting for her at 3:00 in the morning, and I'll be heading to work right after that because it falls from Tuesday to Wednesday. So there's my dedication for the Olympic team and the American spirit. How's that?
Yay, fantastic. Great.
Happy Friday, everyone. I put in a little extra this week because when I was on Zoom, I never went to the website and did the dollars. So I think maybe I'm a little bit behind. But I just wanted to share that I just got back from Croatia on a trip with my family for almost 2 weeks, 10 of us, kind of a once-in-a-lifetime trip. We know that my stepdaughter, is going to be starting a family soon, so we thought this was the summer, the sweet spot to take everyone, and if you ever have an opportunity, it is the most beautiful country I've ever been to. I can't say enough about it, and the family time was priceless.
Croatia must be popular. Somebody else was there.
Yeah, I know a good sailing captain.
Yeah, I hear there's good sailing there. Like, we were thinking about a trip to Croatia for sailing.
That's what Nina just said without the microphone, but she said that she can take you on a trip there.
Well, let's plan it.
My husband is a sailing captain, and he's been sailing in the Dalmatian Islands. And so if you ever want to go sailing there, you can hire him to go, and he'll be your tour guide in the islands and do your and teach sailing if you want.
Good. Bruce, you must be up north.
I am. What was your first clue?
You just got that cabin look in your eyes.
Yeah, I was just wondering, Nina, is that the Dalmatian Islands? Is that where all those dogs are?
Yes, and I actually have a picture of a Dalmatian that I took in the Dalmatian, because when I saw it, I was like, oh, I have to have a picture of a Dalmatian dog in the Dalmatian Islands.
Now we know.
Very good.
Very good.
Oh. Bruce, you're getting quizzed now. Where in the world are the Dalmatian?
Oh, man. The Dalmatian Islands? I don't know. Caribbean? Are they in the Caribbean?
Caribbean. Is that close? No.
Dalmatian. I just got out of bed 5 minutes ago. So I haven't even had a cup of coffee, man. You're catching me woefully unprepared.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have put you on the spot there. It was Nina wanted to know.
What? You lost me. I was busy drinking coffee and I missed all that.
I'm still waiting for my coffee to brew.
All right. Any other happy bucks? Going once. Looking at the
Another
internet.
Another one? Oh, that's okay.
Okay. Thank you very much. We've got, I bet, 30, maybe $35 here that will go to the North St. Paul Food Shelf.
Yep. I got 16 here.
Salvation Army. Oh. Yep. Some of that's going to Salvation Army. And now we have to do a drawing. Once again, we don't have any guests. How about Joe Miller does it? April wins, and what does April win? Is it this bag right here?
Is that it?
Is this more appropriate this week for Olivia? There's some bubble bath in there. She's not enjoying the weekly.
No.
Looks like we got a bubble bath and Rosso stuff. Nice.
Bubble bath and wine.
And wine.
All right.
Take you away.
Please. Bring it back in.
All right. For announcements, club dues. Everyone should have received their club dues in an email. Do you want to say anything about that? You should pay them. I don't know. That's what we got to say. Birthdays coming up. Barry Starr is on July 27th. Thank you again for Barb for taking the whole month and picking up food and changing our menu up and keeping it really nice. So if anyone is looking to help out, we have two days in August, the 6th and the 20th, that we still need some help. That would be great. Next Clay Shoot meeting is next Tuesday, online, Zoom, 6:30. September 17th is our All Hands on Deck event. And then opening it up to meetings and maybe a share out about membership meeting.
Hi, is this on? Okay. I should have just tagged on when Joe was talking about it, but I'd like to thank Char and Myra and Brian and Noemi for showing up at the membership meeting last night at Rotary Parks. We got a little smoky sitting outside there, but it was nice. Just if anybody has any great ideas as far as membership, we've been losing some members lately, and we need to get some new blood in the club. And so if anybody can come up with any great ideas, and or if there are things that our current members would maybe like changed or tweaked or even ideas for breakfasts, please, you know, talk to me or another person on our team, but do appreciate that. And we've been talking about maybe trying to target some of the businesses in the communities and maybe getting them out to talk to Rotary about their business and then maybe encouraging, you know, some of the business leaders to join our group. So, but again, if anybody has any fantastic ideas, I'd love to hear them. Thank you.
Thanks, Barb. Any other announcements?
If we had a brochure like we have, you know, we have this really nice brochure for the clay shoot. Do we have a nice brochure for why businesses would want to join Rotary that we could take around?
I think we have one that needs to get updated.
Okay.
But I don't know if it's a full brochure.
It does need to be updated. It's from 2 years ago.
If president should probably get on that.
You really should. Sorry? I didn't. There can be. I'll put something up there, sure.
Now we both have things to do.
Yeah, perfect. Thanks.
You're welcome.
Announcement, we had a great Rotary Park meeting on Tuesday or what? No, it was okay. Yeah. We are going to be planning a grand opening dedication event. October 9th from like 11 to 2 or so. So we need help planning that. Don't know much about it yet. Just it's a Saturday, yes. So I know we discussed something about some of the food trucks that already have licenses in North St. Paul. Maybe we could get one or two of those to show up and not have to pay them big deposit fees. And then maybe bring in ice cream or something for dessert.
Thanks. Oh. Do you want people to email you if they're interested in helping plan or?
Yes.
Okay.
That would be perfect because we'll be donating that restroom to you guys. 11 to 2, somewhere around there.
Great. Any other announcements? All right, we're going to welcome Terry on up for his classification.
Thank you.
This has been going on for I don't know how many months, being asked to do the classification. So today is the day. Today is the day. I sent Sean a bunch of pictures yesterday. I wasn't sure if he was able to do it, but I heard that people have done PowerPoints, so I thought I'd just kind of share some pictures. And I'm not going to talk about the pictures, but they'll be up there. I guess I'll start out with where my life started. I made national news when I was 18 months old. City boy falls three floors. An 18-month-old boy was admitted to St. Joseph's Hospital about 10 a.m. today with no immediate noticeable injuries after falling three floors to a concrete walk. Terrence Furlong, son of Mr. and Mrs. R.J. Furlong, 1456 Lincoln Avenue, fell from an outside stairway on the third level at the rear of the house where he was playing. Police took him to the hospital where doctors held him for x-rays and observation. Then I made the UP press, so I made the, national news. Terry Furlong, 1½, son of Mr. and Mrs. Richard Furlong, 1456 Lincoln, fell three flights from an outdoor stairway at his home to a cement landing this morning, but escaped with bumps and bruises. Terry was held at St. Joseph's Hospital for observation. So that's my life starting at 18 months old. My sister, they should took her in the police vehicle and took me in the ambulance. But I guess back then, the police arrived first and grabbed me. And it was kind of funny because all the neighbors were sending flowers to my parents because they thought I had passed away. Because when the police came, I was totally unconscious and they wrapped me in a blanket and took me away. So that was 18 months old. And moving on, a little bit about me. I am the second youngest of six. I've got three brothers and two sisters. I've been married to my wife, Sandra, for 35 years this October. I've got a son, Nicholas, daughter-in-law, Beth, and two grandkids, Margo and Maeve. We call them M&M. Daughter, Jessica, which I just mentioned, that having our first grandchild with her. She lives in Austin, Texas, and her baby will be named Aurora. I did mention my son lives in Montana and works at the Glacier National Park. Education, I went to Creighton High School. College, Bemidji State University. I got a degree in business administration with a concentration in finance and a degree in environmental science. My dad was a real estate agent in the kind of the Selbydale area. Not an agent, but he was a house flipper back in the 70s. Not too many people were doing it back then. Towards his retirement, they opened Furlong's Corner right on Highway 36 and Century. That was my grandparents' farm at one time. So my mom started to run our children's and maternity store there, started to retire during that time. And I just want to mention that something happened on that changed my life was on February 20th of 1983 at 8:45. It was 15 minutes before I was just about to go to my first final of that semester, and it really changed my life forever. I received a call from my mother that my dad passed away from a massive heart attack at the age of 55. I was 21 years old at that time. I finished school. I ran the children's and maternity store for about a year. My mother left for take care of her dad down in Arkansas, who's dealing with cancer and end up eventually dying from the cancer. I didn't want to run a children's and maternity store. You know, my mom kind of left it with me, and I told her, I said, "Mom, I don't want to do this." So she said, "Go ahead and do whatever you want to do with it. You can liquidate it, whatever you want to do." So So I did. I liquidated it, and that's when I started the liquor store. I was, here we go. So it's kind of funny. People ask, why a liquor store? And I said, well, it's kind of interesting because back then, Oakdale, we could be open till 10 o'clock. And we were the county line. So St. Paul was 8 o'clock. And I thought, oh, what an opportunity to get those 2 extra hours. And I tell you what, it paid off. It was 1987. Joe, what happened in 1987? Minnesota Twins going to the World Series. You open a liquor store, everybody wanted a drink. It's like the perfect storm. So we were very busy in 1987. About 2 years passed, we tore down the building and built about a 3,000 square foot building right behind where we opened a liquor store. And I thought, oh my God, this is the biggest store ever. You know, 3,000, we go from 800 square feet to 3,000 square feet. Huge expansion, but it wasn't enough. So over the years we grew the store to about 6,100 square feet, about 17 employees, a couple managers. So that was a good thing. So the liquor store, you know, I 33 years ran it. My brother and I, when I sold it last year, I did sell the liquor store, sold it last year. We did about $3.6 million out of that store, which is pretty amazing for a store that size. We had about 13,000 people a month go through the store. So that's a lot of people, you know, through the year. So being able to, when I was at the liquor store, we did a lot of fundraising for a lot of local charities. We raised over hundreds of thousands of dollars for local charities through the many years. A lot of wine tastings, boat cruises. We did a lot of traveling for. We'd get a bus. We'd go to breweries. We did Saints games. You know, just a lot of different fundraising. A lot of fun at the liquor store. But after 33 years, retail was very, very hard on us. When they opened it up to Sundays, it became more of a job. 7 days a week, you know, I just couldn't. Retail, if you haven't worked retail, it can be kind of wearing on you. A lot of hours. So we decided to sell after 33 years. And so that's kind of my career in that. Move on to the kind of my role of city. I was appointed to the city council when Bill Sandberg passed away. I spent 10 years on the council, and I've been 2 years as mayor. Many accomplishments as being on the council and as mayor. The North St. Paul Park Fund, and you'll see a lot of the parks that have been improved with the city of North St. Paul. See, part of Winter Carnival, it's also part of my gig. A lot of new park equipment in North St. Paul, playgrounds, Casey Lake Park building. You know, these are things that I had worked on as part of the council. Veterans Park was a big deal for me. I went down to the state capitol, got bonding money for the project, myself and a few of the veterans, and we're able to build the North St. Paul Veterans Park, and I'm very, very proud of that accomplishment. Church of St. Peter, I was a trustee for many years. We merged two parishes together, and we built a new church, and I think there's pictures there that shows the new church. It was about an $18 million bill for that church. The adventures in my life, I canoed down the St. Croix River with my cousin and two friends for 4 days. I was 12 years old. Wow. You'd never do that nowadays. I look back and I'm going, 12 years old and we're crazy. I hopped a freight train from from Staples, Minnesota to Whitefish, Montana, and hiked in the Glacier National Park for about a week and hopped the train back, and they dropped us right off in St. Paul. It was like the best trip ever. No, this wasn't 13. This was I was 20. I was 20 at that time. And that kind of brings me to today. Is I'm working for Premier Bank. I love it. The Regan family has been very generous for me to be able to work at the bank. And my role is community or business development and community relations. I was Don Regan's last hiree, and you'll kind of read about that in the paper. And yeah, still, there we go. They made national news. But that's kind of my life story. It's been a kind of a whirlwind for the past many years, and I look forward to the next few years and hopefully retirement soon, and that's it. Any questions?
Do you remember what you were doing when you fell?
You know, it's kind of funny because I asked my sister, because she was supposed to be watching me, and she really can't talk about it now, which is, you know, she does have a difficult time, because I think what happened was she was holding me, and, you know, as an 18-month-old, I was probably did something, and off I went. So I do have a fear of heights. Brian. So it's kind of funny. I've talked about this. I mean, this is a good story, because it could take, you know, a whole meeting. But yes, Staples, Minnesota. We're waiting in the weeds, and the train will pull up, and we had a coal train pull up, and go, you know, that's not going out to the West Coast. That's going up north. I mean, there's no schedule or anything. So in comes this train. We waited about 18 hours. This train comes up. And the boxcar is right in front of us, and the door is wide open. We thought, that's our train. So we hopped on that, and off we went. And we're green. We didn't know what we were doing or anything. And got in the train, heading. We're in North Dakota, and it's like 100 degrees out. You don't want to be in a boxcar. It is flipping hot. It is flipping hot. But in the boxcar, they have tie-downs, and we brought hammocks. So there's three of us, so all three of us got our hammocks, and we're just swaying with the boxcar. So it was a lot of fun.
So you guys really planned to hit your train?
We planned to hop a train to Whitefish, Montana.
Do you recall how much money you had?
I had about $50, and I think I came back with $25. That would have been probably 1982.
How did you know that train was going to end up there? So
it's, like I said, I mean, I could talk. Do we have some minutes?
We have all the time.
Okay, so so every train going west is either going up to Canada or it's going to the West Coast. So these trains would pull up, you know, the coal, Great Northern Railroad, and we're going, no, that's not the train. And this train that pulled up had all these new cars from the Ford plant. We thought, oh, those are going to the west. Those are going to the West Coast. So we picked that train, hopped on it, and it took us 30 hours to get to Whitefish, Montana. The train stops. These freight trains stop all the time. And they grease the wheels, and they don't go as fast as the Amtrak. But you're going through every armpit city, because you're in the backyard of their cities, and we'd sit out on the boxcar, we have our feet there, and we'd wave to people as, you know, they're in the crossing, we wave to the people, and they'd wave back and honk their horns. But it was kind of interesting when we first started. You know, we had no idea. They have security on the train, on these railroad yards. So we get up to Fargo, and no, Far. What's the next one up?
The
no. Moorhead. No, not Fargo, the one where the school is. Not the Bison, but the other one. Grand Forks. Thank you. Grand Forks. The train stops in the town, and we hear dogs, and we hear security coming. We thought, oh, my God. So we grabbed our packs, and we flew out of the boxcar into the weeds again. And they came by looking for stuff and went right by us, and we jumped in and went right back in the boxcar, and off we went. And going through North Dakota, like I said, it was flipping hot. We ran out of water, didn't think to bring, you know, a lot of water, and we kind of ran out of food. So we're going, and where does it stop? Our train stops right behind McDonald's. Literally, I mean, I don't have pictures of it, but I had a picture of it stopped right behind McDonald's. We had one guy wait on the train while we ran and just loaded up with McDonald's and water and everything else, and it was crazy. But the whole story, it's a great story, but getting to Whitefish, you're going in at night. It's pitch black. There's no lights. You know, you don't know what town you're in. And we weren't sure how to get off, or, you know, what town it was or anything. So we went through the mountains. We're going through the mountains and coming into this town, not sure if it's Whitefish. And when the train stops, you can hear it stop. It goes, doo, 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 doo. And you can hear it stopping all the way down. So you're kind of prepared for it to really stop. And I had my hands on the side of the boxcar and the door shut on my hands. Oh my God. And I looked and I had like blood blisters on. I didn't know if I broke my fingers. It hurt. So we got off the train in that town and we walked to a baseball field and slept and woke up in the morning and I had nothing on my hands and my hands were fine. It was weird, and we were in Whitefish, Montana. Had no idea, you know. So that was one of the part of the adventure that, you know, you couldn't plan for. You know, the map didn't show this is Whitefish at all. So it was,
given the opportunity, would you do it again?
In today's world, probably not. I think back then, I think there was an opportunity to do it where you didn't have as much risk now, but I think there are, so, say again? I would say no, don't do it. Each town has, when you stop, they have hobo towns. And there's a lot of people that are actually rode the rails. When we're waiting in the weeds, when we're coming home in Whitefish, we're hiding, and the train pulls up. On the way back, we took a flatbed with a semi on the top. So we stayed behind the wheels of the semi. But we're waiting in the weeds, and the train pulls up. We know which car we want to go on, and we run out. And there must have been 20 people that were running out of the weeds, and we had no idea. We had no idea that they were there. So on the way back, we took a flatbed behind the wheels. Another quick story is we stopped at a town, and again, security's coming down, and they got the flashlights. They're checking, and they're kicking. Now you hear they're kicking everybody off. And we're going, oh God, you know, we're behind this semi on a flatbed, and we're in our sleeping bags. You know, you can probably see the sleeping bags from the wheel or whatever, and I'm just shaking in my bag, going, no, I don't want to get caught. You know, I don't know what they do to you. They put you in, I don't know, railroad jail? I don't know. So here comes the flashlight. We're busted, you know, and the wheel kind of had a shadow or whatever, and it just kept going. Three of us, we stayed. We had a guardian angel. So the whole trip had a guardian angel with us. It was pretty amazing. So. Rick. So, yes and no. Peter Hark, He was part of the head of the DNR here in Minnesota for many years. And then Chuck Wedeen, him and I worked together at a camp up in northern Minnesota. And I do not have, it's been a long time since I've been in touch with him. But a story on him is my son moved to Whitefish, Montana. And I showed him, well, we walked down the street and to the railroad yard and showed him where I got off the train, the street that we're came off of, and we're walking down to that baseball field where we spent the night. And as him and I were walking, and this is a true story, Chuck Wedeen calls me on my cell phone.
Wow.
And I go, what the heck? I go, Chuck, how you doing? You won't believe where I am right now. I'm walking with my son. We're in Whitefish, Montana. He goes, oh my God, Terry, you know, I just wanted to call to say hi and see how you're doing. And oh, wow. It's just bizarre. Just wow. Bizarre. So, yeah, it was pretty cool. Yeah, so that's kind of my train story. Yeah, right. So, any other questions? Brian.
Terry, how are things in North St. Paul?
North St. Paul is good right now. You know, I'm sure everybody heard about Scott Dudek, and it was very unfortunate how he left the city. I don't agree with it. We had a plan put in place for him about all the credit cards. About 150 credit cards that were undocumented. To me, it was a unfortunate event. The 2020, I blame it all on 2020. Scott, we were going through about $100 million in capital improvements for the city. Scott took on so much for the city that these credit cards was just not a priority for him. To this day, we have accounted for every credit card that he had used for that. So it just tells me that Scott was busy, the city was busy. He should never have gone out the way he did. But we did have, you know, a council member that was really looking at the activity that was going on, and we had a plan put in place for him, you know, and we had controls that were gonna start with the finance department. And but it just got too much for Scott about the publicity and the social media. I tell you what, social media, it just drives me nuts. I try to stay away from it. So Scott's doing good now. I mean, he was in a bad place a few weeks ago, but I think he's doing good now. The city itself is in a good spot. We have Brian Frandl, who was our electric department head, who's kind of helping out right now, and he's doing a great job. So, but thank you for that, because I think we do need a lot of support from the community, because Scott really has done a lot, so much for not only Rotary, but just so much, you know, for the city itself. So, go ahead.
I went down McKnight yesterday, 36 and McKnight. I cannot believe how fast that project is going up.
It is amazing.
If anybody has not gone down there to see Quick Trip go up overnight and that huge, huge apartment building going up, it's going to change that corner a lot.
Right. You know, and our thought is, you know, as we create, we're creating this community, you know, not only there, but also downtown, and it's going to help our downtown. You know, it's really going to drive what's going to go on down there. We did, I am happy to announce that we are going to have a restaurant that's moving into the new building. I can't say what it is yet, but they should be signing today but it's going to be a nice family restaurant. So it'll be the Sentinel building that they're building down there. Downtown North St. Paul, right on the corner of Margaret and 7th. So it'll be a good family restaurant that you'll be able to go and enjoy the downtown. Go ahead, Barb.
Just kind of going back to Scott,
If they've accounted for everything and he didn't misuse any of the funds or, you know, for him personally, is there some type of article that can be written on this? I mean, the articles in the St. Paul and Minneapolis were kind of defaming him, and even my husband picked it up, and he was like, oh, well, there's, you know, people that misuse all this money, and I'm trying to say, you know, I was trying to explain some things to him, and it would, I think with that kind of case, there should be some follow-up article.
Yep, and there will be. Yeah. Right now, everything's right with the state auditor. So they've collected 3 years of receipts and finances for the last 3 years. The state auditor will have a ruling on it, you know, so we don't want to make an announcement until we get that ruling. Then once that ruling comes out, if it's clean and everything, you know, there still could be something, we don't know. You know, I don't know. But as of right now, we don't have anything that shows malicious activity or anything. But once that ruling comes out, yes, we will be making a statement that, you know, hopefully clear his name and everything. But I agree. We need to, we'll need to do something. Because even the paper articles, I don't like them. They're not, they over, what do you call it? Sensitize them or over dramatize them. They try to sell papers, yeah. Anything else? Well, thank you, everybody. That was a short story of me.
Nice. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Terry. We're going to have you just come up and tell stories like once a year. Once a week story. If we ever don't have a wake-up quiz, it's story time. Let's see, looking ahead, so originally on our schedule, so you'll have a newsletter coming out. The online newsletter will be coming out in the next week or so. On there is where we'll have everybody listed of who's going to be the greeter. Coming up, it's supposed to be Carolyn next week, but I think she's actually out of town, so I'll probably be calling somebody, asking somebody to be the greeter next week. After that would be Randy Comfort and then Sonia, and none of those three are here, so I'll send out messages. I don't know if we have a program lined up for next week. Do you know offhand?
I was actually going to check and see because I'm going to start calling people.
Yeah, so we need programs. That's the moral of the story. We have a bunch of weeks coming up where we do not have speakers.
I just think in the
Let's grab you a mic quick.
Oh,
if I could coordinate with Christine, superintendent of 622. There's so much happening with construction and redistricting the boundaries and new schools. I think it would be great if we could have her and just come talk about what's going on and hope maybe share some pictures. The buildings are beautiful. I don't know if you've driven by Carver. I know that's a little bit not in North St. Paul, not right here, close by. But it is just stunning. It's going to be amazing for the district of 622 to have these wonderful buildings that have capacity and capacity to grow in our community.
That would be great. Yeah, if you want to check with her and see
I'll check with her schedule.
Fridays work.
The next two Fridays we're looking for.
Yes, next two Fridays. Thank you.
Hey, I have a thought.
Let's hear it, Bruce.
Hey, amazing. I got a thought. Well, now I got my coffee. Today's program was so much fun with Terry. I think we have a wealth of programs right in our club that, you know, so many members that have come in that are new that don't know some of the older members. I think these personal stories are great, and they make for great programs.
So, Bruce, are you next week? Is that what I'm hearing you say?
I think I might be around. Sure, I'd do it.
Write that down. Everyone heard it.
If you want.
Bruce is up next Friday.
I've got kind of a boring back. Well, never mind.
Save it for next week.
Okay. Okay. I'm in.
We're all showing up next week. I'm in. All right. Let's see. I think any other announcements that anyone has or... want to make sure we captured those. All right, so next Tuesday, clay shoot meeting, please attend so we can, I think we had really good progress last Friday with getting things set in group, so we'll do announcements out at that time and make sure we're moving that forward. Thank you to everyone who brought in some alcohol and wine for the clay shoot. Please keep that coming. Our wheelbarrow definitely needs more. And yeah, for next week, if everyone could bring one bottle of wine, that would be great. Have a great week, everybody. Please stay. We have a few minutes left here, so stay around and chat. Have some more breakfast. Have a great weekend. Meeting adjourned.